suitable distancing cannot be maintained. During the offertory, please bring your offering to the altar where the offertory baskets for the church and the presbytery are provided. Please observe social distancing as you bring your offering to the altar. The same applies when receiving Holy Communion. Please observe social distancing. Thank you for your cooperation. Under no circumstances should anyone awaiting a COVID-19 test verification, including clergy, attend a church or parish setting until a diagnosis is confirmed. Additionally, under no circumstances should anyone attend who is closely connected to people who are awaiting test results or who have tested positive. Taking pictures or recordings during the celebration of Mass is strictly prohibited. You may take pictures after Mass. Please respect the right to remain the privacy of everyone. Thank you. Brothers and sisters, on this third Sunday of Advent, the liturgy speaks to us, people who are too often so sad of God as the Lord of the dance. The Lord is happy to come among us. He will dance with shouts of joy for you as on the day of festival. It is a feast for the Lord to be with us. Is it a feast for us too? Let us open ourselves to the joy of the coming and lasting presence among us of the Lord Himself. He comes to us with His peace, His love, and His forgiveness. Not on the great feast of Christmas, but in every Eucharist and every day when we are willing to make God's love and peace grow in us and in our world. Lord, we are happy that you are here among us. Please rise and join the choir in singing the gathering hymn.
Joy in the face of uncertainty. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace and praise of God and the virtue of the Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And so we sanctify the Mass for the congregations. For those who congregate in the very days, we meditate in Spina, in the Son, those who be proud, to be in one. Likewise, for the healing of babies and his dear family, Romel and Antony Luis, Aubrey Barley, Sammy Mooney, for one of the guests, the family of our King Jesus. Likewise, for the souls of Rinaldo and Rafael, Amara Castro, Vinicius Reyes, Lidia de Seco, Luz Cinco, Lidia Corintino, Rosin Prado, or Anna Copribane, Celestina Gonzalez, Maria Estelis Sinia Lay, Still Fastila Lay, Angelina Lay, Lekium Ho, Anastasia Trivium, Lumi Martinez, Romaldo, Anita de Seca, and Veronica, Vinera, and Paul, so the simple. Our priest will sacrifice the last day as possible to many of our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. I confess
to Almighty God, and to my brothers and sisters, that I have received in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask that Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, who have blessed Jesus, the very glory of the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us life everlasting.
Amen.
Rising, this
The Spirit of God came to him and he reclaimed his poem. He said, "The oracle of Balaam, son of God, the oracle of man with his far-seeing eyes, the oracle of one who hears the word of God. He sees what Shaddai makes him see, receives the divine answer, and his eyes are opened. How fair are your tents, O Jacob! How fair your dwelling, Israel! Like valleys that stretch afar, like gardens by the banks of a river, like meadows planted by the Lord, like cedars beside the tree waters. A hero arises from his throne. He reigns over countless peoples. His king is greater than Hagar. His majesty is exalted." Then Balaam declaimed his poem again. He said, "The oracle of Balaam the son of God, the oracle of the man with far-seeing eyes, the oracle of one who hears the word of God, of one who knows the knowledge of the Most High. He sees what Shaddai makes him see, receives the divine answer, and his eyes are open. I see him, but not in the present. I behold him, but not close at hand. A star from Jacob takes leadership. A scepter arises from Israel." The word of the Lord.
Christians should always be joyful people, says St. Paul. Their joy must be contagious, for the Lord is always near to them.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. I want you to be happy, always happy in the Lord. I repeat, what I want is your happiness. Let your tolerance be evident to everyone. The Lord is very near. There is no need to worry. But if there is anything you need, pray for it, asking God for it with prayer and thanksgiving. And that peace of God, which is so much greater than we can understand, will guard your hearts and your thoughts in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This Sunday, brothers and sisters, is the third Sunday of Advent, this known as Gaudete Sunday. Sunday of rejoicing. Sunday of joy for the coming of the Lord. This is a very significant Sunday, brothers and sisters, for the Lord's coming ushers a new kind of holiness, a new kind of joy. And as Paul is getting in the second letter, the letter to the Philippians, in the reading, rejoice in the Lord always. In the Lord we have always a reason to rejoice. In the first reading from the prophet of Zephaniah, brothers and sisters, it was in the context of religious degradation. The pure motivism of Moses has been delegated with the belief of various gods and goddesses. People were led astray. People were known as sinful. And in the midst of this experience, brothers and sisters, the prophet Zephaniah then has told them that the Lord will be coming first to chastise them, to punish them. But part of this punishment is the feeling of joy, feeling of being renewed, feeling of being cleansed. So as well in the first part, or in the whole part of the reading, it says, shout for joy, daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, rejoice, exult with all your heart. Now if you realize, brothers and sisters, the Lord does speak to us when we are sinful, when we have committed transgressions, but nonetheless, that will be a venue for us for a renewal of heart. So if the Lord will punish us most probably, it was also a time for us to see how God loves us. Not for us to be punished, but to check us when we are in trouble. When we are led astray, the Lord made us straight, so to speak. And this is the cause of joy on how the prophet Zephaniah in the first reading is telling us. He will exalt with joy over us. He will renew you his love. He will dance and shout of joy for you as on the day of his love. So another time, as you mentioned, it's a time for us to be chastised, so to speak, but a time for us to be joyful. After all, we have been checked, we have been corrected on our vision. Our relation in life had been strengthened, so to speak. This is the joy that Gaudete Sunday is telling us, brothers and sisters. Joy coupled with repentance, joy coupled with enthusiasm to be renewed, to be converted, to experience a time of better. Now, in a very difficult season, brothers and sisters, on Paul's letter to the Philippians, we realize Paul has been a very beautiful inspiration to the Philippian communities when he was in prison. Now, naturally, we experience a sort of problems and difficulties, much worse if we are in prison. What is coming in a person are vindications. Anger, hatred. But in the person of Paul, he was telling us, we have to be always joyful for the Lord will be coming in our midst. A joy of the experience of the Lord even in the lowest moment in our lives. Just like Paul in the second reading, in the Lord, he speaks to the Philippians, while he was in prison, and yet expression of joy, an expression of affluence, an expression of persuasion that the Lord will never forsake us, will never abandon us, will never leave us orphans. Now in Gospel verses from the Gospel of Luke, joy has not been mentioned, but nevertheless, three sets of people asked John on what must be done. Now, after the preaching of John, people realize that his preaching would have just fall on deep ears. Something concrete, something specific has to be done. And it will always be telling us that the experience of our preparation for the coming of the Lord is not merely an experience of praying. It's not just merely an experience of goodwill, but a very concrete expression of how the Lord will be worshipped by us. So, first of all, we're asking, what shall we do, teach you? Do you know the response? For those who have two tunic, give the other one to the needy. For those who have more food, share the food, not just the extra. Yeah. Meaning to say, first aspect of the best preparation for Advent, the coming of the Lord, is from the perspective of generosity. Sharing a little bit. Second group of people, tax collectors. What was that by John? No extortion. Get only the things that you should be asking for. No extortion. Be faithful to your calling as tax collectors. The third group are the soldiers. What were the words of John the Baptist? No intimidation, no extortion, be content with the pain. Meaning to say, if you are given such power and authority, it should be in function to our calling, and it should be always for the common good, not for personal, selfish interests. Soldiers are in themselves people vested in power, authority. But these people should be serving the community, serving the people now for the community. Three sets of people representing all of us, people in us. How about that? Have we asked the Lord what shall be done in the season of Advent, preparing for some Christmas? Is it? Have you asked yourselves what will be done? If you're working in government, what will be done? Many people are doing that. Most 95% are not working at home. So meaning, if you're working at home, you have what? The control in terms of number of hours. Are we honest? If you have to begin at 9 o'clock, did you begin at 9 o'clock or maybe begin at 11 o'clock with a sleep? For the meantime, you need while nobody watching it. No manager, no supervisor, only the. Okay, completed. Do like that, maybe. Or we could make some money over. So are we honest as persons? If you're working in government, are we trying our best effort to be ourselves totally and wholeheartedly for the job, not for our sake, but for the sake of those people whom we are called to serve? So all of us, by the sisters, should ask the Lord what has to be done. Depending on what kind of life we are founding. We could be working in government, we could be working, by the work. We could just be staying home. If we are a parent of your parents, what could be done in this season of Advent? Could we possibly give more time to our families? Could we possibly give more time to our kids? Or maybe we could give more time to our cell phones, your tablets, your computers. If your kids is going to be studying in reality, even after repeating all the time, even during meal time, instead of talking directly, kids' parents just text, you need to engage personally. Engage through computer, engage through cell phone, is very, very impersonal, very impersonal. So maybe this season of Advent could be a season of us reestablishing our ties, strengthening our personal interpersonal relationship with our kids, with our parents, with our grandparents. And indeed, this is how we should ask John the Baptist to how to prepare well for the coming of the Lord. From the second part of the Gospel, it says that people were under pain expectancy. They viewed John as somebody, the Messiah whom they were waiting for how many years. But again, John was telling them, I am just merely a voice coming from the wilderness, preparing for the way of the Lord. I am baptizing you, Lord, as somebody who literally will be baptizing you with the Holy Spirit. That even when by his thunder struck, I am and won't do it. Then the Lord increase and I have to decrease. In order to gather the sisters, all of us also are called to be John the Baptist in our own simple ways. Always preparing, always paving the way. And if the Lord will be known, let it be, he's the boss. We are the simple and worthy servants in God's kingdom. So we continue this way, sacrifice of the mass and sisters, or coffee and cutting, then the very core of how we should prepare with expectancy, with joy, with peace, with hope for the coming of the Lord in our peace. Then in the Father, in the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, was the substantial of the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake was glorified and lost his life, his suffering went in the third, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and to sit down the Lord and glory. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the Lord of God, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who in the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, was spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess our baptism and for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In this truly of the joy among us, this perhaps because you are Christian enough, let us pray to the God of joy. That may always give his peace and joy, let us say. Lord, you are all our joy.
Lord, you are all our joy.
For the church, that it may always proclaim the gospel as good tidings of great joy, as a message of liberation and hope for all. Let us pray.
Lord, you are all our joy.
For today's cold world of management and production, with its manipulation and injustice, that we can again pay attention to people and regain a sense of joy and celebration. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and those who suffer, that we may give them not only what they need, but bring them the warmth of our love and the joy of hope. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians everywhere, that we may learn to keep our serenity in the trials that are part of life, and that we may see the relative values of things. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us, that we may have a sense of humor that can laugh at our own expense, and a sense of gratuitousness that can do things for free and out of pure joy. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our Lord, our God, help us to get up through Jesus, your Son. May we give your hands as free people and people of good joy. And this we ask to praise our God.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, this is a time to bring your offering to the altar where the offertory baskets for the church and the presbytery are provided. You are all encouraged to wear face coverings and observe social distancing as you bring your offering. Thank you for your cooperation.
With thrones and dominions, with our Father in heaven, we during the Holy Word, the form of the Lord of Holiness, make clear for this sacred prayer, which is near to the people, to the Trinity Conference, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before it was given up to them, all the grace.
Thank you.
And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from the evil, which God these still days, by the help of the Lord's Spirit, hears with the sins of the Spirit, and surely the blessed Lord, and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. O Lord Jesus, the apostles, we say to you, by peace thy name, look back on our sins and the faith of the church, and we stand at peace in the goodness of the world, live and reign forever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us all hear the strength of peace.
Mm-hmm.
For some few announcements, there's no 7 a.m. Mass from 16 December until Christmas Day, this is on the 25th. Normal Mass times will resume on the 26th of December. For the Mass times, it is in our parish bulletin. There will be the 9-day Mass, Dawn Mass Lubina, the first day of Lubina on Thursday, the 16th of December, which is 5 a.m. until the 24th. For the confession, it will be Monday to Saturday, 30 minutes before Mass. Please approach the priest in the sacristy. No confession is Saturday vigil and Sunday Mass. For food sponsors, if you wish to sponsor food as a family or as a group for the Dawn Mass, please contact Jimmy Gallardo. The mobile phone is in here as well. God bless you and your families. COVID safety marshal volunteers needed for Dawn Mass, Christmas and weekend masses. Please call the parish or email our parish as well. And we sincerely thank the altar server, the readers, the collectors, the excellent ministers of the Holy Communion, the presiding priest, Father Rowan, the choir, the Holy Redeemer choir, and everyone who attended the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Have a blessed week and stay safe. Thank you.
Let's pray. May you pray in mercy to the Word, that this divine sustenance sustains us for our faults, and prepare us for the coming feasts. In this we ask the Christ of God.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And tell your heads to pray for that. Bless you. May the Lord give you. May He show His face to you. All of mercy. The
Amen.
Merely to serve and love Him.
Thanks be to God.